While evangelicals remain an important demographic group for politicians, the percent of Americans who identify with any religion has been on the decline for decades. And a recent Pew Research Center study has found the biggest generational drop-off is with millennials, young adults born between 1981 and 1996. Kat Wise reports from Southern California on the young people who are changing their beliefs and the efforts by some faith communities to bring them back. And a note, the Pew Research Center is a NewsHour funder.
We're all together in this thing.
A Sunday service that is part therapy session.
Imagine how that would change the trajectory of your life.
Part stand-up comedy routine.
I was this, and then I was this, and now I'm this. Give a little bit.
And part live concert.
Give a little bit of my life for you.
What's up, guys? How are you?
All followed by a round of beers with your pastor in a rented CrossFit gym. This is not your grandmother's idea of church.
We want everyone to be able to hear the good news, so we had something right in the back. Do you have good news?
Welcome to New Abbey, a Christian, LGBTQ-affirming, progressive, family-friendly church in Pasadena, California.
God, we thank you all of the time.
It was started 6 years ago in the living room of this guy.
For all of the ways that we don't believe that we're human enough or good enough. Or
Corey
okay
Marquez
enough,
is a 34-year-old ordained pastor who left a larger evangelical congregation after he saw many of his own friends were no longer interested in attending church.
When you were talking to your friends about why they didn't go to church, what were you hearing from them?
This isn't relevant for me. Sexuality, that's a big one. Like, the church is not honestly talking about sexuality.
You can ask my wife.
Sexuality is not a taboo topic here. Marquez's fellow pastor, Brittany Barron, speaks openly with the congregation about being a lesbian, and many of those who attend are from the LGBTQ community. The congregation has grown from 20 to 400 over the last several years.
It's less about form and more about content, that people want something that actually matters for their lives. So if the content is literally not healing you, connecting you to something bigger, then you're wasting your time.
New Abbey is one of a number of new religious organizations popping up across the country trying to appeal to young people who are increasingly leaving the religions of their ancestors. According to an October report from the Pew Research Center, 76% of the baby boomer generation describe themselves as Christians. In contrast, only half of millennials identify as Christians. 4 in 10 say they are religiously unaffiliated, and 1 in 10 identify with non-Christian faiths.
This is what interests me, like if people say they feel nothing.
Diane Winston is a professor of religion and media at the University of Southern California, who has been studying religious trends among young adults.
Many religions just don't feel relevant to a lot of these young people. They don't speak their language. And now there are other ways you can make those connections. You can make them online. You can make them at an interest group or an affinity group.
She also says many young people have lost trust in religious institutions.
There's scandals, the sexual improprieties, these problems of, you know, pedophilia, of sexism, of misogyny. Why would you want to give your time and money to an institution that countenances or protects people who do these kind of things?
Some of those turned off by traditional religions continue to seek fulfillment in other ways. According to Pew, 3 in 10 adults ages 18 to 49 now identify as spiritual but not religious. One of those who has made the switch is Jason Perez. The 32-year-old from Los Angeles was raised Catholic and attended weekly services with his family. But he says he never felt truly connected to the church and left in his early 20s.
As a queer person, the Catholic Church is unsafe. I go to church and I'm immediately sinful. It's this feeling of not being able to show up fully myself.
Now he works as a healer at Mostly Angels, a store specializing in mystical services and products in Culver City. Perez says there's been a significant uptick in business over the last 3 to 5 years.
We're not sold on the old fantasy of what the church can provide you, what spirituality, structural spirituality can provide you.
While New Age practices and beliefs have been growing since the 1960s and 70s, the internet and social media have played a big role in the spread among younger generations. More than 60% of adults ages 18 to 49 have at least one New Age belief, according to Pew, and many are turning to new horoscope apps and online astrologers for guidance.
In the final moments of Shabbat, as
but some favor much more intimate ways to spread the word.
In what ways do we take on the challenge of wrestling with our shadow?
At the Open Temple in Venice, California, Rabbi Lori Shapiro incorporates a variety of New Age practices, even a colorful bus, to reach new people in the community.
There are a lot of reasons why people have fallen away. I think the least of which is ideology. People are hungry for these ideas. We just need to make them accessible again.
But many faith leaders aren't rushing to change long-held practices and beliefs in order to keep young people in the pews.
The story goes on to tell that while he was teaching...
Reverend Mary Miner is the pastor of Brookins Kirkland Community Church in Los Angeles's Inglewood neighborhood. The church once had 10,000 members. Today, there are about 300, and many are older adults.
Do you feel, in an effort to reach younger people, that the church might need to change its views on certain issues, like gay marriage, for example?
I don't think the church needs to change that. My denomination does not believe in gay marriage. However, my denomination embraces those that are of the LGBTQ community.
According to Pew, Black millennials tend to be less religious than older Black adults, but they are considerably more religious than their peers. Reverend Miner says she's concerned about losing so many young people in her church and worries they are missing out on an important aspect of religion, community.
When you're not assembled with believers, then you feel like you're on an island all by yourself.
Paul's trying to do two very important things. First, he's trying to give you a new understanding of who God is.
Back at New Abbey, Pastor Corey Marquez says a sense of community is what's bringing people back Sunday after Sunday, and their approach isn't all that radical.
I've never opened a door in Christian tradition where I found that I was the first person there. There have always been people, monks and priests and nuns and theologians and philosophers who've been asking these questions for thousands of years.
Once the congregation finishes pondering life's most ancient and enduring questions, they get to celebrate with pizza and cold beverages. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Kat Wise in Pasadena, California.